So one question that we get is, how do you insulate a home in the extreme hot or the extreme cold? Let's talk about it. So let's think about a home in an extreme hot or an extreme cold situation. And you start thinking about, well, how would you want to insulate this house? Obviously, at a very basic level, you want to make sure it has more or at least more effective insulation in a less cold or a less hot environment, right? So for example, if you have an average outdoor temperature of 70 degrees year round, well, you might not have to worry about that much insulation to begin with. But let's say you live in an environment where it's 30 degrees. Every day. And sometimes it gets down to negative 30 degrees. Well, naturally you would think, well, I'm going to need more insulation, or the insulation that I do use needs to be better. It needs to perform better than an insulation in a less harsh environment. And that's really the basic principle here. So if you think about your building materials, what is the best insulation material that you can give in extreme cold or in extreme hot situations? Foam is typically what gets landed on. And you think about things, you think about tractor trailers, that you semi-trucks that you see traveling all over the country. A lot of times that load has to be heated or cooled. If you were to go inside the wall of that tractor trailer, they're foam lined, almost always. Some of the older ones do have a fibrous material, like a cellulose type of material, but they're usually foam lined. If you think about your hot coffee, you're probably going to put that in a very insulated container, maybe a really fancy tumbler that you got on sale at Target or something. You're going to want that to stay as hot as long as possible. Same thing in your home. If you put a home in an extremely cold environment or an extremely hot, you want to make sure that house is shielded and protected as much as possible so that the temperatures you create on the inside are retained. That's really how insulation works. However extreme your spectrum is, it's the same principle. If you're just taking a couple drinks into the garage for the evening, you don't necessarily need a crazy cooler for that. You might be out there for an hour or two. But if you're taking the family to the beach for the day and you got all kinds of waters and Capri Suns and snacks and stuff in there, and you're gonna be gone for 12, 15 hours, you do probably want kind of a premium, super expensive cooler to make sure that little Timmy's Capri Sun is gonna be icy cold at 3 o'clock when he's got a hankering for some juice.
It has the juice?
Your environment will always dictate, but the principles stay the same. If you're in a more harsh environment, you just want to be that much more diligent that you're using the best materials possible. If you need an air seal, for example, in a very windy, harsh, cold environment, having a material like foam that does help establish that air seal, that's going to be key because, again, you want to fit for that environment. There's a ton of different analogies. I'll end with this one. When you're thinking about your fridge or your freezer at your home, this is a perfect example for an extreme transition of temperatures. The temperature inside your chest freezer is far different than the temperature inside your home. If you were to cut open that fridge or that chest freezer, what is lining the walls of that? Foam insulation, because it's simply the best material to stop heat from transferring in extreme or harsh conditions. So no matter where you land on the spectrum of hot or cold, if you're ready to take back the comfort and control in your home, go to our link below to our Find a Dealer page, where you can talk to your local Retrofoam dealer and learn how you can make your home more comfortable and energy efficient today. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.